What are guys? Well, what are we doing? AVIs. We're going right now in our continuation of wiring the 1UZ to the Haltech. I'm going to connect some AVIs, some analog voltage inputs. I'm going to start with the water temp, the EFI water temp, that fella, which is mounted there. This one is for the gauge. This is the cold start injector timer. Not all engines have that, and it's not required for an aftermarket system. This is the EFI temp sensor. So that is very, very important. And we're putting in an air temp sensor, which happens to be this plug. And we have modified our throttle body to accept the sensor in the back, like that, running a Bosch open element sensor. So I do recommend, when you're putting in your engine, when you're prepping it, to fit a new water temp sensor, EFI temp sensor. Of course, it does give you the ability, when you're putting it in together, to put a different one on if you want. So you don't have to use the Toyota one. I do because it makes it simple for me, because I keep a lot of the Toyota ones here, and I replace a lot of them for normal jobs and for normal computers. And when I'm prepping engines, pretty much every engine gets one. Well, I've done my yellow wire, which happens to be my temp sensor first, and that will be AVI 7. That will be AVI 7, which is in pin B3. So it's really easy when you've just done the cam and crank. It's right next door. And poke it all the way home. Go on. Oh, there it goes. And then I used blue for water. That kind of makes sense, doesn't it? That blue is water. Oh, got terminals here. So to make the engine run properly, you probably only need 3 AVIs, and that's analog volt inputs. And actually interesting, with the Haltech, doesn't have any digitals. You just use your analog as well. So that would, the 3 that you need are water temp, air temp, or you could probably get away without air temp. So water temp, definitely, and TPS, definitely. So in goes my water temp wire into, I'm going into B4, which is AVI, just wait a moment, AVI 8. Now I need to put the terminals on the sensors. Green sensor here, green sensor plug. Now these are not polarity conscious, so it does make it pretty easy. I'm going to put the signal into pin 1. Factory, it's actually normally the earth on pin 1, but I pretty much put all my positives on the engine on pin 1, unless it specifically doesn't work. So two wire sensors. Pin 1 is the power, such as this air temp. Injectors, pin 1 is the power. And it just keeps it very, really easy when you're testing. That's my air temp and my water temp fitted. And of course, if you want to know how to set them up, I did a video on that the other day. Now, each of those sensors has a ground. Over here, I've got all my sensor grounds, all my AV sensor grounds, analog volt sensor grounds, and the powers are the red ones, or the 5-volt supplies. On this particular vehicle, I have fitted quite a lot of other sensors, as you can see. So those, that earth needs to be earthed back to the correct point on the ECU, which is signal ground, B14, 15, or 16. I'm going to do that later on. Right now, although, I'm going to do my TPS. So the TPS has a 5-volt going out there, and it has an earth. or a sensor ground, 0 volt. Here's a factory Toyota TPS plug. And they're numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, same as the other ones. So number one is the sensor ground. So we'll put number one, sensor ground. Number four at the other end is the 5 volt. Now, with being four wires, the wire beside the ground, beside this, the 0 volt, is an idle switch, and the actual TPS signal is the one beside the 5 volt, so pin 3. Let's make the signal white. And let's put the ground, let's put the idle switch in pin 2, which is going to be green. Of course, I don't have a choice. That ad always has to be the idle switch, and we push the lock in. TPS is white. So I did wire in the idle switch, but in this case, I'm out of analog inputs to put the idle switch in. In a normal situation, we would have the ability to put that in there. No big advantage on this particular job. I'm really just filling a hole at the other end. So we're gonna just put the TPS signal into the ECU. Haltech actually recommend have some AVIs already set up, but you can put them anywhere you want. In this case, I have chosen AVI 10, which is the default Haltech set placement, which happens to be in the A plug, pin 14. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Now, if they don't want to pop all the way home, actually just give them a little bit of a prod to make sure they do get all the way seated. Those are the main analog volt inputs. Hope that's been helpful. We'll see you in the next video when we put something else in.